Chart imitates life. This summer, we did a chart imitates life about people who are running for Congress for next year, blue or Democrats, red or Republicans. These are people who are running who aren't currently in Congress, so non-incumbents, people who are running to try to get a seat in Congress who don't already have one. Now, all of these candidates have filed formal paperwork with the FEC saying they're going to run, and they're all serious candidates in the sense that they're all starting to run. They haven't just declared and filed the paperwork. They've all raised at least $5,000 toward their campaign. These are numbers as of June 30th. And this shows you the best way to look at this is that these are for numbers the year before somebody's going to run. So where it says 2003, that's people trying for a spot on the ballot for the 2004 election. Where it says 2005, that's people trying for a spot in the 2006 election, right? For our purposes, though, take a look at 2009. 2009, big difference between the Democrats and the Republicans, right? Twice as many Republicans running that year as Democrats. Tons of them running. In hindsight, that spike in Republican challengers running in 2009, that was an alert that the big Republican wave election was coming in 2010. And Republicans picked up a huge number of seats in 2010. They picked up 63 seats in the House and 6 seats in the Senate. You could see that wave coming because of how many more Republicans than Democrats were jumping out of the gate early to run that year. Well, now, look at this one more time. As we showed you in July this summer, this is for next year's election for 2018, Democrats, boom, flooding the zone ahead of the 2018 elections. 209 Democratic challengers compared with 28 Republicans as of June. Well, 3 months later, as of September 30th, look at this. The Democrats have pulled even further away from the Republicans. It's now 391 Democratic challengers compared to 71 Republicans. 5.5 times more Democratic challengers saying, game on, I'm in, when compared with Republicans. If that lopsided count of candidates in 2009 was a harbinger of Republican domination in 2010, what does that lopsided count this year tell you about what's coming up next year? Midterms are only 323 days away.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.